Welcome to episode 4 of Drinking from the Flame. And if you are watching from the last episode, we have just defeated the Cursed Rotted Greatwood. So we're down here in the Undead Settlement. And here is a sacrificial altar made of bones. Offer a vertebra shackle. Excellent. Let's get out of here. So yeah, I thought this time I might we might clean up a little bit some of the quest lines and things from earlier. There are a few things in terms of lore that we kind of skipped over, like who was Vought of the Boreal Valley, that a dog knight that we kind of took care of in episode 2. Now he's one of Pontiff Sullivan's Outrider Knights. So the Pontiff sends Outrider Knights to the far reaches, as the name suggests. But we've got a few more things that we have to do in the first few areas, so we might head on. I'm making my way back towards the tower, and once we get to the tower, I might show you what we're drinking today. Let's take care of this evangelist. Now, an evangelist, their job is to evangelize and bring people from the Undead Settlement, or encourage people to come from the Undead Settlement and devote themselves at the Cathedral along the Road of Sacrifices, which is the next direction we'll be heading. Should be fun. Squish. Oh, I love that literal Bible bashing that's happening there. We don't often get to hear enemies speak in plain language, so that's always fun. But yeah, we're going to make our way back up the tower. Yeah, we're going to be doing a lot of bonfire traveling, so I'm not going to worry too much about my health at this stage. Let's, oh! Got caught in that one. So we're trying to head up the tower. So we're going to make sure the lift is right. And we're heading back to the place where we fought the fire demon. To make sure we get a particular item. So we can finish off a quest line back at, the high wall. So we can see that there's where we want to hop off. So we get off here, hop back on, and we'll fall off on our way down where that lantern is. So we'll drink another Estus flask, although we're not going to run into any enemies. So there's a, like I said, there's a particular item that we want to get. This little area is one of my favorites, just visually. I love how there's fire everywhere, and you've got these little people in chairs slowly turning into trees. Whether that's related to the people on the high wall that are turning into trees, I'm not sure. But see that item up there in that corpse? That's what we're after. Let's see if we can... There we go. Just knock it off. So we got a pale tongue. Which is about all we came for at this point. So we could jolly well homeward bone back to the shrine bonfire. And while we're doing that, let's have a look at what we're drinking. Now this is a Balgoni Black Label 2013 Shiraz, which is, this is a Shiraz region, so we have a lot of it, but I believe it pairs well with action RPGs, especially Japanese ones, with dark European aesthetic. Yeah. Let's see if our friend is here. And there he is.
Well, hasn't it been some time?
It has.
I'm Leonard, the Ringfinger. Remember me? I slipped you those red eyes.
I do indeed.
You're making quite an effort of it, so I thought you might like to know. If you yearn for a proper red-eye orb, one that is uncracked...
Oh, that's really nice.
...then kill the Dark Wraith, survivor of the man swallowed by darkness. He has been a prisoner for many ages in the deepest cell in all...
So we're heading back to the High Wall.
I can see it in your eyes. If you didn't invade, didn't pillage...
Yeah, that's me.
What do you do?
I can see it in my eyes.
If you fancy up, then kill the Dark Wraith. He has been a, I can see.
Now, by no means is this going to be a complete playthrough in terms of getting every item or anything. This is just just a fairly average playthrough.
Are here firmly planted, for I am a lord.
But we do have an item that we need to give to Ludlith here, which is the transposing kiln.
Oh, belike it is. A transposing kiln,
which is what he's going to use to turn our boss souls into weapons.
It shall suffice. Now, bring to me a twisted soul.
Indeed, I shall.
Transposition is the art of extracting and coalescing the essence of a soul. In transposing a twisted soul, its true power transferreth to thee.
I do like true power.
Thy purpose is to seek lords and slay them.
So the way he's talking about it makes it seem like it's probably not, it's probably something that's frowned upon. But so in terms of Vort's soul, I think we're going to go for this hammer, which requires 30 strength. And we're currently at 20, but I reckon we'll dump a few in strength and we might use it along the way. So we'll take that. So you can, there's always two options for each soul. So let's gain some levels. Like I said, we'll dump them in strength.
Very well, then take them.
Okay, so we're now on 22 strength, which is nice.
Farewell, Ashen One.
And while we're here,
I
think we have
Ashen One. Bring me with. Is it not?
Okay, so we don't. There is some ash that we're missing. We need to give her some umbral ash. And we haven't actually spoken to the pyromancer yet, which we'll do. But first we'll talk to the blacksmith.
Weapons and protection are sturdy enough by and large. But when overused, when their durability, use a power, should I say so.
And if we keep talking to him, we get hurrah as a gesture. Nice. So we don't have any Estus Flasks upgrades. And I don't think we have any bone shards yet. Oh, we do! Okay, so now we can upgrade our Estus Flask so that it does recovers more health. Now, we might go speak to the Pyromancer while we're here. Who is now located down here.
For trust as promised, I will at first. You need a flame of your own.
So now we have the pyromancy flame.
You don't burn yourself with it.
Okay. So I enjoyed pyromancy last time. That's my preferred mid-range combat. But, yeah.
To learn pyromancies, I know. And do not be gone.
I'll try not to be gone for long. Now, we can see over here our friend Grey Rat is
heavens.
Sad. So we get the curl-up gesture.
Heavens.
Now we have a key to a cell, so we're going to go use that key back on the high wall. So we go to the tower on the high wall. We'll see how many glasses in this playthrough. Hopefully not too many for my health's sake. But man, that is good. So we know that there's a dark wraith locked up in a cell. So we're going to head there now. What I might do is also fight this this knight again, just in case. Just in case he drops anything, which he didn't, but there you have it. So we'll head down. Now this is not going to be the kind of playthrough I would normally do, where with lots of grinding for cool weapons and armor. I figure we'd try and keep it as brief and natural as possible. So that's why I dressed in this ridiculous outfit. And down. Okay, so we have the lift chamber key. This particular encounter is, spoilers, difficult and not much fun. He has far, far too much stamina for my liking. Let's see if we can get a sneaky backstab on him. Excellent. Okay. So you can see he's got way too much stamina. And he's very kicky too. Okay, so you can see from that he just he doesn't break his poise very easily. Okay, and down. So we've got a pale tongue and a red eye orb. So so that was not so bad. Might save our homeward bones and walk back to the bonfire. So we've essentially cleared up this this whole area now. We want to go back up the ladder to the bonfire. Now just as a reminder, our task is to return the Lords of Cinder. So those who have linked the flame previously, return the Lords of Cinder to their thrones. So we need to put them in the kiln to rekindle the flame. We're going to travel back to Firelink Shrine and have a chat with our friend. In fact, now I've got 5,000 souls, we can probably whack another level in strength. Get closer to using that hammer.
Brilliant. I knew you were a dangerous woman.
I am a dangerous woman.
Now
thank you.
Invade and pillage all you like.
I don't think I will if it's all the same to you.
You too may become a finger. Come on.
Do you love fingering?
Give yourself to Rosaria of the Cathedral of the Deep.
So So we'll chat with the maiden here.
Welcome home, Ashen One. Speak thine heart. Very well. Then touch taken.
Okay. Another strength. So we're level 27 at the moment.
Farewell.
We're going to head back to the Undead Settlement, to the dilapidated bridge, and there's a particular item that we want to give to the handmaiden. You note the handmaiden looks a lot like Emma, who we met in the last episode. So we've got the giant on our side, so we can make a nice run through here, not have to worry too much about getting whacked. We can thank the giant who's over there. Now, you'll notice even if we do get hit with the bolts, we don't really get hurt, which is most excellent. Now, there's a particular item that I'm looking for, which I can't seem to find yet. And if I can't find it, then we may have to postpone. But, hopefully it shows up. We'll have a good look around here. This little graveyard. Now there's that chap who'll fall down on us. And I think I just spotted the item. There it is. Okay, so the mortician's ashes. So ashes are what we give to our dear friend. Actually, if we make our way through the building, I think there may even be a chance at a... Oh! At a summon sign that we can use. Oh! Thank you very much, kind sir. Could be wrong, and indeed I am. It's happened before. So, yeah, no, there was no summon sign. That's fine. So we're gonna work our way. No, we're not. We're just gonna use a homeward bone. Go back to the shrine bonfire, and hopefully we've got enough souls to purchase a particular item, which will be unlocked once we give the ashes to the shrine handmaid. So give umbral ash, give mortician's ashes.
Fine ash thou hast given.
Oh, thank you.
Let this ash bestow nourishment. I only hope these new wares content thee.
Oh, thank you. So we need just 1,500, so we're going to sell some souls. And we'll purchase the key. We may even...
Ashen,
how many souls do we have?
Be sure to bring me.
So we have 6,000. I reckon we can dump another one in levels. So we're now level 24. We're getting closer and closer to being able to use that giant ice hammer that we got from Vought's soul. Now that we've got the key, we're going to travel to the cliff underside. And, actually that was probably not the closest, but that's fine. We're heading to see some new friends. Okay. Let's see how we go fighting. This chap getting super enthusiastic. And she... Oh! I thought she was finished. Oh, I love these doggies. Okay, so we're going to head this way, and into the sewer. There was a door that we couldn't open before because it was locked and we didn't have the key. The grave key. And what do you find in graves? Skelly bros. A loincloth, excellent. So this is the statue of Velka. So we can request absolution or dissolution. If we sin or turn hollow. Okay. What could go wrong? Everything. Hey buddy, not see you there. Oh, giant skeleton. Axes make short work of them, which is nice. Let's drink a potion. You can see these skeletons have vines growing up through them, which is super fun. Them a little more distinctive. So we try and get these guys against walls so they can't run away. Done. So we got a heavy gem. Another Titanite shard. And this chap. He's going to attack us. And done. Obviously it gets quite quite tense. So I'm often not good at talking and fighting at the same time. Ooh! So there's a hanging thing. Let's see if we can see if we can hit it. This could take forever. Getting closer. Try this way. Close. Close. Closer. Got it. Ho-ho! Blessed red and white shield plus one. Oh, that sounds fun. Let's see what that's like. Okay, so it's got low physical. Let's read about it. Wooden shields are light and magical. It just looks pretty. And hey, that's all it needs to do. Be wary of trap. Okay. Excellent. Oh. Well, that wasn't so bad. Lots of rats. And a saint's talisman. So we can feel saintly. Now we get to meet a couple of characters that we briefly saw.
Who is there? Someone there? Anyone?
It's me.
Please, whoever you are, touch me.
I will.
The dark surrounds me, nibbles at my flesh. Little creatures, they never stop biting.
So she's clearly blind.
So please,
which is important in terms of the story. Touch.
Oh, yes.
It's not how you touch people, but...
So close, indeed.
Let's refill while we've got some talking happening.
Just yet. Praise the merciful gods above.
Oh, I got prayer.
Oh, forgive me. I am Irina of Carim.
Hi, Irina.
I came to this land so that...
We'll meet a few people from Carim.
Your touch has freed me from the darkness.
Am I a champion?
A champion, then. I am weak and unfit to tend the flames. But if it would not trouble you...
Please enter my service.
Oh, thank you, sweet champion. I shall take my vows. I, Irina of Carim, solemnly swear to serve you.
Wonderful. So she teleports herself back to the filing shrine. And then we can have a chat with this chap.
You've gone and rescued her, have you?
Indeed I have.
How very quaint. Pitying creatures that are beyond help.
For all his laughing,
I'm sick of looking.
He does care about her. So much so that he'll try and murder you if you do anything to her.
A knight of Carim.
Hi, Egon.
I am allied to you for as long as you assure the girl's safety. And
no worries.
Only for that long.
Yeah, that's fair.
What's the matter? My terms are very simple. I am allied to you and only... What's the matter? I am an only...
Yeah. Okay. So, now that we've done all that, we're going to press on and head downwards. And we'll have one of the trickiest encounters in the early parts of the game. So I apologize if this takes me a while. Now these are, you'll be able to tell by the design that they're related to Vort of the Boreal Valley. And Ember. I wonder if he likes fire. We're out of fire bombs. So we can use throwing knives. Oh! Let's drink. Ho ho! Frostbitten! Like I said, this could take me quite a few shots. Murdered in the face. I think more shiraz will help. I apologize for the little pauses in the video, which are not much fun. But, there you have it. The lady fell down. The evangelist. If you have a look at the evangelists, they have beards drawn on with charcoal. Which is adorable. Love it. Excellent. Now we should be good to just run. So, we're going to try and fight him again. And hopefully not suck as much. But no promises. Because I'm really good at sucking. What? Now I want to go down. This particular enemy drops a really awesome weapon. In fact, it was the main weapon I used in my first playthrough. And it lasted me right until the end of the game. Oh! Oh, frostbitten. Does a nice chunk of damage. Oh! Oh! So we're gonna run. Drink an Estus. Or two. And then see where our friend's at. Now you've probably got an idea. Oh! It's very hard to get backstabs on this guy, thanks to how agile he is. Oh! Okay. Okay, so that was essentially the same thing happened there. Hopefully we're doing a little bit of damage each time. Indeed we are. And done! Whew! So yes, that was... we got the Irithyll Straight Sword, lovely. So we cheesed him a little. But there you go. Now we are finished with the Undead Settlement. Here we arrive at the Road of Sacrifices, which connects the Undead Settlement to the Cathedral of the Deep. And, like I said, this, this particular, road was used to transport, undead to the Cathedral of the Deep for reasons which we will discover as we go. Yeah. I forgot to heal up, so we might take this opportunity to rest at the bonfire and get back some health. Let's see what equipment we have. So everything is not quite as good as what we're currently wearing, so that's fine. Hopefully as we go, some enemies will drop some nice outfits for us. So you can see that particularly annoying attack. Flurry of scratches. Lovely. And here we find the soul of an unknown traveler. Wasn't so bad. Oh! That was. I might wait for him to return. Excellent. So that scream we heard in the background was this guy summoning people. Let's drink some Estus. And then take him out. Oh! Hey buddy! Lovely. Thank you. So as long as we keep them occupied with axe swings, we're fine. Okay. Are you going to come down here? No. Brigand axe. Oh! Yes. That was fair and well deserved. Oh! And that's gonna be the end for me. Let's refill. Now I can feel this shiraz taking hold, so let's go a bit slower, shall we? Get out of there. Finish that one off nice and quickly. Have a look around here. Is there anything we've missed? No, but we do get to see a little secret path ahead of us. That was much nicer. And we get the butcher's knife, which is a lovely, lovely item. And the brigand set. And if we go further, we get twin daggers. Now let's just have a look at the stats on the brigand armor. So it's less by all accounts. So we still haven't found anything as good as what we're wearing. Same goes in terms of helm. The gauntlets are slightly better. So we might equip those. And they look kind of cool with this outfit. This very uncool looking outfit. You can probably see my eyes are starting to turn red. Now we'll clear out this chap up here. Titanite shard. So we'll refill our Estus. And I died. Now I was trying to get to a secret path that I completely misjudged where it was. So we might rush ahead. Way, hopefully we won't get spotted. Done. Sorry, buddy. Corvian Great Knife. Nice. Now, let's get my souls back. Here is where I meant to land. Take care of these doggies. The Braille Divine Tome of Carim. So, we know who to give that to. Who needs to read Braille and is from Carim? The lady we just rescued. Let's get some Estus in us. And we'll get rid of this chap with a backstab. Now it's much easier to you know what? Let's actually use a take care of this. Lovely. And an ember. And finished. I can feel my responses slowing down. But we're doing quite well, I think. And who have we got here? We have another bonfire. And some friends.
Oh, hello. How do you do?
I'm well.
I'm Anri of Astora. Unkindled like you.
Oh, hello.
This is Horace, a friend and travelling companion. Are you too in search of the Lords of Cinder?
Indeed I am.
We're well along the Road of Sacrifices. Below us is the Crucifixion Woods. Beyond the
flooded woods
lies Farron Keep, home of
Imagine there's lots of crucifixion.
Further yet is the Cathedral of the Deep. We seek the cathedral, home of the grim Aldrich. We may go our separate ways now, but we are both seekers of lords. The next time we cross paths,
Aldrich.
One may find the other in
we'll want to remember that name.
May the flames guide your way.
Thank you.
Oh, yes. Horace. He's not very talkative, but don't think ill of him. He is an upstanding, kind-hearted knight. A fine partner for this grueling journey.
Yeah.
Without
his You're both help, adorable.
I would have cursed this onerous duty long ago.
Let's have a chat with him. Oh, I got the blue sentinels. He does not say much.
We are well along the Road of Sacrifices. Below us is the Crucifixion Woods. Beyond the flooded woods lies Farron Keep, home of the Undead Legion. Further yet is the Cathedral of the Deep. We may go our separate ways now, but we are both seekers of lords. The next time we cross paths, one may find the other in a time of need. May the flames guide your way.
May the flames guide your way.
We are well along beyond the flooded wood. We may...
There we go. So we might have a seat at the bonfire, refill our Estus, and make our way down. Now we do have enough to level up, but we're really close to another bonfire, so Might, Right. Take this opportunity to light the next one fire. We may even have enough for two levels by the time we get there. Let's hop down here. Lots of poison turtle chaps. And there are items scattered everywhere. Twin Dragon Great Shield. I believe that is the Great Shield that slowly heals. I'm not very much mistaken. My fire still makes short work of these doggies. And here is another bonfire. So we're progressing quite nicely. Oh! Upgrade materials we have. So we have 4 Titanite shards. We'll travel back and level up at the Firelink Shrine. Now one of the really cool things... Oh, look at this!
You're an unkindled, aren't you? I am Sirris, of the Sunless Realms. Former servant of the divinity, duties we each bear, but one's duty is a solitary affair.
Indeed.
A blessing of the moon upon your journey.
Thank you.
I doubt we've much to gain from fraternization. Blessing of the moon upon you. I doubt we've much blessing
fine.
Of the moon upon your journey.
Now, do we have? I think we have some souls we can sell. So let's sell them, shall we?
Welcome home, speak very well, then take none.
And we have 12,000, which should be enough for 2 in strength. So we're at 26 already, and we want 30 to wield that giant ice hammer.
Farewell, Ashen.
Let's see what pyromancies this chap has for sale. Ah, welcome. So we've got Fireball. Yeah, not much of a requirement, so we may as well buy it, I think. And we'll get upgrades later as we go. So we'll attune that. First we will equip the Pyromancy Flame. So we can swap to it when we want to use fireballs. And let's attune some spells. Insufficient attunement slots. Okay, so it looks like we have no attunement slots, which means we will have to put some levels into attunement. But we want to work on strength first, so. Go back to the Crucifixion Woods. Oh. And this chap followed us in. So we're going to meet another NPC very shortly. I always feel bad about whacking the ones that aren't interested in me. The heretic staff. Call me a heretic. It essentially looks like a white branch. Lovely. Nothing around here? No. But I do love smashing things. So, we're working our way towards a particular boss in this direction. And these guys are much like the Grave Wardens from the initial graveyard you wake up in. Yeah.
Well, this is unexpected. I don't often have visitors. What do you want? This is my study that you've happened upon. If you haven't any business, I've reading to get. How intriguing.
I do want to know sorceries.
You'd better not. And should never. You have your own methods. Don't let it bother you. Be on your way then. You're unkindled.
So, oh,
well, nothing has changed. It is either naturally on your way or unkindled.
So basically, I do not have enough stats in intelligence. But that's fine. So what we might try and do is attack the next boss. Who's not particularly difficult. Now, over there is a... Oh, there's a hole. We don't want to fall in a hole. So we might go collect that item, which I believe we get this way. If we head around the other side. Get the drop on this. Lovely. So we fairly easily dispatched of those enemies. Now here we have a summon sign, which we can use to help us beat the upcoming boss. Now these guys are actually much easier than the undead that we meet on the high wall, who use the same spear-shield combo. But, let's bring Aegon into the fight. We might keep this episode fairly short. Once we beat this boss, we might take a break. Now that I'm quite a few glasses in, over half a bottle, and we've got Aegon with us. Now there are lots of items that I haven't collected yet, but I think now might be a nice time to... You can see this boss is fairly squishy. And teleports. But has a wonderful, if you can see, plague doctor mask on under that giant hat. Now, sages wear big hats, and this is the Crystal Sage, in honor of Big Hat Logan. Now we want to find what's going to happen next is the... We want to look for the one that is purple. Oh! Blue, 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 and this one is purple. So I might take another Estus while I'm here. Okay, purple is over there, so... quite well. This is one of the easier boss fights. Except for a purple one. There's a purple one! Couple more hits. And they are finished. I love the crystal effects. It's blue. You don't want to worry about that. There's a purple one. Oh. Done! Thank you very much, Aegon, Knight of Carim. So we got the Soul of the Crystal Sage. And we had a lot of fun. So we'll light the bonfire here. And before we finish up, I might head back through, because we haven't used that many Estus flasks. We'll head back through this area and collect some more items. This castle I actually completely missed on my first playthrough. You have to finish it in order to finish the game, or you have to complete it in order to finish the game, but I had done everything possible that you could do before I found this area. I went in a completely different direction. Oh! And I'm dead. Which is handy that there's a bonfire just there. How far wrong could I go, eh? I apologize for that. We left our souls up there. Okay, the same thing is going to happen. So I'm going to move outside and drink an Estus flask. And we could go down there and collect some items. I think first we might finish up these folk. Yeah, we'll finish off this whole area. Okay. So there's not too much more here, although if we go down here, there's an item out here. A ring of sacrifice. There we go. So, we'll head down and pick up that item and see all these adorable crabs. Green blossom. And a giant crab. Probably don't want to fight at the moment. So you can see there are lots of items in this one. We'll head back up here. Head out in this direction. Golden Falcon Shield. Let's see what stats it has. If it hasn't got 100 physical, I'm not interested. No, it doesn't. Large Soul. Okay. What do we reckon? Can we take this chap? Good when they work together. Hide behind a tree. Run in this direction, eh? Drinking Estus. Wait for him to finish his flurry of attacks. I'm gonna get ganked if I'm not careful. So I might sprint Estus up. One down. Great club. I don't know how great it is. I don't know where the other chap went. He possibly died as well. Okay, so we can see this door is broken. We're going to come back here later. And if we have a look, we can see the high wall where it disconnects, or we can see the wall where it disconnects, and there's Lothric Castle up there. It's always nice being able to see where we're going to go next. Now if we head down here, I think he fell down here. So we'll light this bonfire, and we'll travel back and level up before we forget. We can hear the gross, slimy noises of slugs. What? Out of wine? What is this? Okay, so there's not too much of a bottle left. It has been a good Shiraz.
Welcome us. Very well, then take them.
Now, we need, okay, how are we going? Might put, one into intelligence, why not? Seems like the intelligent thing to do.
Farewell, Ashen.
Farewell to you too. Now, do we have any more items that we can burn? If we use that, the large soul and unintrepid, we get another 1,000. Now, I think we need at least 10 intelligence.
Very well. Then take no.
I could be wrong, but I think we do. So now we should, if I'm not much mistaken, be able to speak to our friend. So if we go to the, which is the closest, I still think Crucifixion Woods is slightly closer. Oh. Okay. So I'm gonna head towards the castle. Oh, there's an item here that we missed. Soul of an unknown traveler. I'm just gonna keep running. Oh! And occasionally it doesn't pay off. Did this time though.
Well, well. Though indeed I am a sorcerer. However, what champion demands service without recompense? Clearly you are not that sort of woman.
Indeed,
so you
I am
will
not.
Make me a promise that in exchange for my teaching, you will bring me knowledge.
I will bring you
in
knowledge.
A form of scrolls detailing sorcery's secrets. Well, can you assure me of this?
I can.
Very well. You're no fool. I take it you understand the weight of a promise.
Mm-hmm.
I am Orbeck.
Hi, Orbeck. Vinheim. Lovely to meet you.
Unkindled one. I shall teach you sorceries. We will learn together. It shall be like our very own school.
I don't think I'm going to get through a bottle, but it is very nice. Now that he's gone, let's wreck up the place! Oh, that is so satisfying. Scrolls everywhere. Okay, so we're gonna make our way to the next little area. Although, let's fight one of these guys, because they are some of the hardest enemies. Oh! We can make it to the bonfire, so if we die, no big deal, eh? Now that we've led them away... Oh! And there's a doggy. This is pretty much the only way I can play now that I'm very, very intoxicated. Let's get this. An ember. Oh! And an Estus shard. Lovely. We got all squished. Estus shards, we know what they're for. We will travel to the Firelink Shrine, upgrade our Estus flasks, We will also meet Orbeck. So Orbeck hangs out just here.
Oh, you're back then. Again. I'm Orbeck of Vinheim, here to teach you sorceries.
Lovely to meet you.
The basics. The ideal sorcerer bears the twin faces of the dragon. You could at least act as if you're paying attention.
But you're so boring, Orbeck. Yes, I are.
I don't mean to seem overbearing in exchange for my slender form, I hope.
Yes, there you have it. So we'll reinforce our Estus flask while we're here.
What neat.
Wonderful.
Pretty.
Now let's get our souls back. Crucifixion Woods. You may notice I have a new chair. Which has been lots of fun, much more comfortable. I might take these on one at a time. Oh! Chewy. And down. Here are my souls. I don't think I'll wake that chap. And, let's progress to the next area, shall we? I'm gonna... Next bonfire we get to, I'll... we're gonna finish it off, I reckon. Next bonfire we get to, we'll call it. Because I will definitely be too intoxicated to continue. But thank you so much for joining me for drinking from the flame. I hope I got the name of my my show right. But yeah, Dark Souls 3, easily one of my favorite games, and I was not anticipating that I would enjoy it. Because it seems such like a real like gamer bro type game. Which is really not me. But there's a real beauty to everything. It's very very sure of its identity. And it really, really does that kind of gothic horror so well. And I think that other guy's just completely lost now. No, he's not. Out of here. And finished. We can grab another Estus while we're here. Oh! Blood loss. we hide behind these rocks, hopefully that spell will deflect. Oh! Get some more health in us. Have to be a bit more liberal with the flasks now that I'm a bit more intoxicated. And she's down. Whew! So we got the Herald armor. Lovely. We'll see how that compares. So still not quite as good. It's very interesting that really early armor that you get can be just as good as fairly late armor. Now, we might swap to this because it's a little less ghastly to look at. Whew. And I think we'll call it there. Actually, there's one NPC. We'll finish off with this NPC. Actually, before I tackle that NPC, I should probably sit at the fire and get my Estus flasks back. Now we'll tackle this this particular character. So that stance is not a happy one. Oh! Oh. Let's keep our Estus filled. Oh! Good shot, you. Oh. And I think we're finished. But yeah. That's, that's been finishing off the Undead Settlement and made our way through Crucifixion Woods and the Road of Sacrifices, and we beat the Crystal Sage. But, thank you so much for watching and joining me and my bottle of Balgowny Shiraz for Drinking from the Flame, Part 4. And I hope you'll join me again for the next episode. Where we will have a different grog and a different boss, I'm sure. But if you want to find me elsewhere on the internet, I'm at @moststrange on Twitter, Instagram, and Tumblr. And I produce content for theactionpointspodcast.com. So visit the Action Points Podcast for all things geeky. And I'll see you on the next episode. Bye!